Hi, this is David McCam for WebTNG. In this video, I'm looking at the performance aspects of some popular Gutenberg block plugins. People often like using Gutenberg-based solutions when they create their sites because they say it's close to core and it's performant like core. Yet, at the same time, the common wisdom is that you need to use a third-party block collection because core is too limited. This presents a conundrum. By using a third-party Gutenberg plugin, do we run the danger of adding a lot of overhead and so self-sabotage the site performance? Here's another way to phrase that. Can you add the features Gutenberg is missing, yet still be performant like core? Or can you have your cake and eat it too? In this video, I'm comparing 10 third-party Gutenberg block plugins with WordPress core, specifically focusing on performance. While testing, there were a few things that caught my attention that I think you'll also find interesting. Okay, so to test, I created a website on my local machine. Now, in the article that accompanies the video, I have a long section on how the testing was conducted, so I'm not going to go into that in detail in the video because it just takes too long. But I'll show you the process that I took. Is I start with a blank website and add the Query Monitor plugin because that's going to be one of the things that's used to generate the stats. And then I add the block plugin that's being tested. So here I'm adding the Greenlight Blocks plugin. Activate that. Then I go to a page and I repeat the same process for each of the plugins. I create a page called Test Page. And then I use the blocks from the plugin. So I add a container, ideally a section. Then I add an H2 and give it, this is a test page. And then I add a paragraph or special text element and type in the quick red fox jumps over the lazy brown dog. And then I add a button and give it the text, click me. Okay, and I check and make sure that everything is in the container as expected. And then I save and view the page on the front end. And I refresh it once or twice because sometimes the very first time it's loaded, the numbers might be a little bit higher for the amount of memory used in the database queries. But after the first time, they don't change. And so we see that the Greenlight plugin is using 36 megabytes of peak memory. The Query Monitor plugin gives us 4 stats: the time to load the page, the peak memory usage, time to run the database queries, and the number of database queries. I'm using the peak memory usage and number of database queries. So I record those, and then I open the page in a private window and go into the dev tools. There is a little snippet here that lets us count the number of DOM nodes. It's a little faint there, but it says 122. So I record that. Then I go to the network tab and reload. And I record the size of the page in kilobytes. So that's how I get the stats. Then after I'm done with testing a builder, I reset the site, and I'm using a plugin called DevKit, and it has a reset option. And one of the nice things about this is it doesn't, you know, leave anything behind when it's deleted. There's reset database, reset content, empty WP content folders, delete all plugins except for DevKit, delete all themes, and reset. Okay, and now we're here and there are no posts, there are no pages. We've just got the 2025 theme. DevKit is the only plugin. I remove that and then start over for the next test by adding the plugin Query Monitor. Okay, so that's kind of the cycle that I use. There's one other thing I've done is in the WP config for the site, I added some things here. One disables WP cron, and these two disable the automatic updates. And I did this so that, you know, I want to cut down on any background processes going on. So that's the way the testing was done. Now let's go and look at the results. When I did that same process, I used the core container block, a stack, and added those same elements as I showed you. I found that core used 33.4 megs of memory, had 23 database queries, 125 nodes, and 166 kilobytes for the page size. Okay, so I've got those in here. And I've got the version that was tested also in this raw results table. If we look here, we see that Etch, for instance, used 3 more megabytes of memory than Core did. So rather than do the math and look back and forth for each of these as we're going along, what I did is I recorded the differences down here. So Etch, you know, used 3 more megabytes of memory. You know, Etch had 40 queries, Core had 23. That's 17 extra. But Core had 125 DOM nodes, Etch only had 122, so minus 3. I did that for all of the plugins that were tested here. I tested Etch, Generate Blocks Free and Pro, Greenlight Blocks, GreenShift Blocks Free and Pro, GutenKit Free and Pro, Cadence Free and Pro, Nexter Free and Pro, Otter Free and Pro, Spectra Blocks Free and Pro, and Stackable Blocks Free and Pro. And I'm mainly going to focus on the Pro versions, but there are two things I wanted to show you in this table that has Free and Pro. So the first is, if we look at, for example, GutenKit here, it used 5.5 megabytes of memory more than Core for the Free version, but 9 for the Pro. And that holds true, Free, Pro. You know, and it's not, I guess, too surprising. The Pro versions are probably doing more. The same is true for database queries. For the most part, the Pro version does more queries than the Free version. There was only one place where that didn't hold true, and that was for AutoBlocks. Free has 31 database queries in the Free, but only 20 in the Pro. So that was kind of an oddity, so I looked. Query Monitor lets you see the queries. And I saw there were 8 more queries in the Free version that were fetching the options that had been set and were stored in the options table. And that told me, yes, you can optimize these plugins. And that's an example where someone optimized the Pro version, you know, to not query over and over again for the settings. But that didn't happen on the Free version. So that's something that perhaps the OtterBlocks team can optimize. All right, now let's go and look at the Pro versions. I want to focus on Pro because that's what I use. You know, I always use the advanced dynamic data features. So here's what we have here, and we've got 4 categories. Memory usage, it's a peak memory usage. number of database queries, the DOM nodes, and the page size in kilobytes. And this is in addition to what Core uses. And these tables, I'm using the Ninja Tables free plugin here, and the tables are sortable. So let's look on memory usage. And we see that green light blocks only use 2.6 megs of memory more than Core. Etch 3, generate blocks pro 4.2, green shift blocks pro 4.3. And then it doubles here, about doubles. So these first four are more performant than the rest. And there was anomaly when we look at cadence blocks pro. It was using 23 megabytes of memory, more than Core K, which is more than 60% more than the next closest, and kind of double what is in the middle tier there. So seemed like maybe there's something going on there that the team could look at. Okay, but anyway, these four here obviously stood out as being the most performant. If we look at the number of database queries, if we sort by that, again, we have green light blocks, and we have green shift blocks pro, cadence blocks pro, and then Gutenkit and Nextr blocks. Then we start to jump, and we see here these are doing twice as many or many times more than the ones with the fewer database queries. If we sort on DOM nodes, generate blocks pro, four less elements on the page than Core, which is amazing that we have some that are even more performant than Core. So we have generate blocks pro with minus four, etch and green light blocks minus three, and green shift blocks with two nodes more than Core. All right, so very performant there, obviously, you know, better than Core. And then if we look at page size, we see that, again, we have a more performant tier. The Generate Blocks Pro, six fewer kilobytes than the Core page. Green Shift Blocks Pro, five less. Etch and Green Light Blocks, four less kilobytes than Core. And then if you go to the other end, you have Nextr blocks with 143 kilobytes on the page more than Core has. These three are obviously much bigger page size than the others. What I did to take this one more step is I gave a score to each of the results. So I sorted first by memory usage. And the best one, best score there got a 10, second best got a 9, then 8, 7, so on, right? So I did that for each of the categories. I think memory usage and probably page size are the most important. But I did the scoring for each of the categories and then added them up. And what we see is that green light blocks got 36 points. Generate Blocks Pro got 33 points. Green Shift Blocks Pro got 31.5. Etch got 29 points. And then we start to drop. Pretty consistent throughout that these four stood out as being very performant. And in some cases, like with number of DOM nodes and page size, even more performant than Core. So at the start of the video, I asked the question, is it possible to use a Gutenberg plugin in addition to Core and still be performant? Or are you going to sabotage yourself if you add a block collection to Core? So we see here now, if you are concerned with performance on this level, that there are several choices that stand out as being more performant than the others. And so I think that in the case of Greenlight, Generate Blocks Pro, Green Shift Blocks Pro, and Etch, you can have your cake and eat it too. So that's my look at 10 Gutenberg add-ons and comparing their performance with Core. Hope you found this video interesting. If you did, please give it a like and subscribe to the channel. And again, all of the details of the test are available in the article on the website, and there's a link to that in the description below. Thank you for watching.